Hey, you guys, it's Peter, and I'm back. Of course I'm back. I'm not going anywhere. Boost! Peekaboo, I see you because I'm YouTube famous now. Da 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 da. There's no business like YouTube business like no business I know. Can you guys wait? You can't wait until the drum opera of 2021, and it's gonna be on Broadway. Listen, it's gonna be a one-man show. Me and Jeffree Star, Jaclyn Hill, Manny Muir, Nikki Tutorials, James Charles, hi sisters, Laura Lee, subscribe, Patrick Starr in the house, Raw Beauty Christie. Boost. I just remembered a dream that I had. I had a dream that I was talking to my neighbor from next door, and I said something about like it being really quiet because it's been snowing and it's been so peaceful. And she was like, quiet except for you singing at the top of your lungs while you were making videos. I just remembered that she said that to me in a dream. Anyway, the album, Dad, AF. Rock on! I went to a party last Saturday night. I didn't get laid, I got in a fight, it's the end of the world as we know it, and I feel fine. Oh my God, when I was in high school, I had such a crush on Michael Stipe from R.E.M. Anyway, let's get into today's video. How are you guys doing today? Today we're gonna talk about, I was looking for my notes right here, but I also have my meditation books because I'm going to film my meditation video next. I have already today filmed my vlog. I have also filmed a video for my Peter Does Stuff channel. I took everybody to my magical place. Thank you so much for the support on my new channel. I'm having so much fun over there on Peter Does Stuff. So I did that video. Then I did a BookTube video. And I also did a review video today of the January Blizzard of the Month from Dairy Queen. So anyway, I have just been busted out the videos today, and I have already posted a video today because I filmed the video yesterday, and then all this stuff with Trisha Paytas and Jay, Hair by Jay, and all this stuff popped off. So I posted that video last night that I filmed in the parking lot. I hadn't done that in a while. And I said I was gonna do a follow-up video today, which this is kind of a follow-up video, but some other stuff I wanna talk about in here as well. Like Jeffree Star, obviously understanding the importance of principles. Even though he chooses when to apply them to his life and when not to. And then I also want to talk about Trisha Paytas getting the apology that many people, I think most people, feel that she deserves from Hair by Jay. So let's get into that. Are you ready? Now, I posted this other video that I filmed yesterday today. So it's kind of like drama from yesterday. You get it, right? So anyway, my husband is texting me. What is he texting me? A link to something. Let's see. What did my husband text me? This is going to be it was a TikTok. So anyway, my husband and I, we just send TikToks back and forth to each other. Do you guys do that? Oh my God, I love it. Okay, so let's get into what happened. Now, if you didn't watch my video from yesterday and you're like, Peter, what are you talking about? Okay, did you sleep in a cave overnight? I don't know. But anyway, what happened was, about a week ago, I think it was, because I saw that the video had been posted like a week ago, this Hair by Jay, who is Jeffree Star's wig person, supposedly he is a wig stylist to the stars. I had never really heard of anybody that he did besides Jeffree Star, but apparently he's done some major celebrities. He came out in an Instagram story rant against Trisha Paytas. Go watch my video from yesterday. I got very, very heated in it because I just could not believe the things that this man was saying about Trisha Paytas. Now, y'all know if you watch my videos, I'm not the first one to defend her. I think we know that she trolls quite a bit, and she has had a lot of things to say too. But it was really painful watching this video and hearing somebody. Okay, this Hair by Jay was not trolling. I think we have to kind of remember that, you know, when we're talking about the situation. He was not trolling. You could tell he was really angry, right? And it was because apparently Trisha Paytas had come out in a vlog and she had said some things about the situation, which occurred a year ago in Las Vegas. I've seen a lot of comments from people that are like, Trisha needs to get over this. This was a year ago. Well, okay. I mean, I think that we all have things that have happened in our lives, whether that was a year ago, 6 years ago, 16 years ago, 60 years ago, that still bring pain to us, right? And she even says in her video that she did, because she did a video yesterday called Why, I think it's called something to the effect of Why I'm Scared of Jeffrey and Hair by Jay. And in there, she said that she was triggered by some of these things that had recently come out. So she's watching the video of him, the Instagram story by Hair by Jay. And if you watch my video from yesterday, I took notes, but he called her the most horrendous names. He attacked her weight. He body shamed her. He said she looked like a walrus, that she had warts. He talked about her skin. He said she probably needed to go on a diet. He threatened her in the video. Apparently, he had doxed her. He showed like some private information about a company of hers and her phone number, allegedly. On and on and on. And when I watched this man talking about her, I thought, which he later describes as being reactionary. Okay, I've been reactionary before. I've been reactionary in anger before. And I'm not proud of it. It's not a good look. It's something that, you know, I've really, really worked hard on the last couple years. And I today choose to respond to situations instead of being reactionary, which would be a major suggestion I would make to this Hair by Jay. Because if Jay is getting this upset about something that Trisha Paytas said to him, I think you're probably extremely reactionary about a lot of situations in your life. So anyway, he goes in here. I watched today, he came out and he made an apology to Trisha Paytas, which it was an apology. He did say, I apologize to Trisha Paytas in the thing, but it was like, let me put on my lip gloss for this. Have you ever watched somebody give an apology? I mean, you want to talk about bad apologies on YouTube. Have you ever watched somebody give an apology that is such a save their ass apology because they know they have to do it? And I don't know about anybody else, but I didn't watch this and think that he was apologizing, because he wasn't like, okay, if you go watch it, which it's up on YouTube, you guys can find it. He is not reading from a script. He's just talking to the thing. It's like a 4-minute clip that I saw. He goes in there and it's not like he's like, oh my God, you guys, like I'm so embarrassed. Like I really went off. Like, you know, like I can't believe that I said those things about Trisha. I was so fired up. I really don't typically speak about people that way. I shouldn't have said that. I mean, he doesn't, it's not natural. It's not genuine at all. Okay. And so I'm sitting there watching it and I'm like, now, Jeffree Star has been involved in this because people were saying that Jeffree Star needed to come out about all of this, of which, if you watch my video from yesterday, Jeffree Star responded to this, and what Jeffree said was, hold on a second. Somebody said, why would you want that little SHI tit working for you? You're a professional business owner. Don't have people like that in your life. What he said was so incredibly mean and wrong. He's a little bully and you're better than that. And Jeffree said, I've been in Wyoming and had no idea what was going on. Just catching up now and I am horrified by what he said. Let's not pretend I had any part in that. Okay, well, that's a tweet. So you came out and you said that. So I guess we need to watch closely to see if Jeffree continues to work with somebody that speaks this way. I think that will speak volumes going forward. Because when I watched this apology from Hair by Jay, I didn't feel that it was an apology. I didn't feel like it was a heartfelt apology. That's just my opinion, okay? I didn't feel like he was doing it to protect his brand because he's been posting on Instagram. Well, yesterday, he turned his... He's such a hard ass, okay, that he turned his Instagram on private because apparently people were saying stuff and sending him stuff that he just couldn't handle. So he turned his Instagram on private. It's no longer private today. And this is where he went on his Instagram story. But he was posting all these things on his Instagram story, basically showing all these people's hair, including Nikita Dragon, that he had done in the past, right? So I don't think he's real worried about it affecting his brand. So then why would he come out and apologize? Because he doesn't apologize until the very end of the clip when he says, and he really isn't looking at the camera and he's like, yeah, I need to apologize. I apologize to Trisha Paytas and all this kind of stuff. He says something in there about not being able to say her. He doesn't know how to pronounce her name correctly and all this kind of stuff. And then he apologizes to her. But I'm watching it and I'm thinking to myself, he is apologizing to her for one reason only, and that is because Jeffree Star got on the phone and said, you need to apologize to her. Okay, which that's the right thing to do if he did do that. I'm glad that Jeffree said that to him. And he's apologizing to save face with Jeffree Star because he wants to continue to work with Jeffree Star. Because Jeffree Star has flown him places and has paid him a lot of money and all this kind of stuff. Which actually, Trisha brought up in something, I think, you know, or somebody brought up that it's like, weren't you flown all these places too? Okay. So, you know, and you're talking about Jeffree Star and you're talking about Trisha Paytas and you're talking, because like what she said is he's got your name in your mouth because Jeffree was like, don't bring me into this. I don't have anything to do with it. Okay. So here's my real issue with it. Well, first of all, let me talk about what he said in the video. So, he said in there, I have never had an issue with Trisha, and I don't have an issue with Trisha. Or I don't have an issue with Trisha now. He said something to the effect of that in his apology. Well, you obviously did have an issue with her, okay? I don't know how you talk to friends in your life, or just people that work at the Starbucks, or the greeter at Walmart, or your servers at restaurants, or just people that you work with, or your clients. I don't know how you talk to clients in your life, or just family, or whoever, okay? But to body shame somebody when you're in the beauty industry, okay? And a lot of people, when they saw this, were like, if this is who Jeffree Star supports, I got a message from somebody or a tweet from somebody that said, if this is who Jeffree Star supports, then that makes me wonder, as somebody that likes him, how he feels about people that are overweight, how he feels about people that don't have good skin. Like, if that's what he and Jay are talking about behind the scenes, and who knows, right? I mean, like, maybe Jeffree's never been part of that conversation. But this person was speculating and saying, If that's how Jeffree feels about Trisha Paytas, and does he feel that way about the people that are like, you know, have supported him all this time? So anyway, he goes on and says that, I've never known anybody that didn't have an issue with somebody that spoke to them so harshly. I mean, like, you obviously do have an issue with Trisha Paytas. And I would rather if he came out in a video and said, or an apology video and said, I do have an issue with Trisha Paytas. I have an issue with how she handled this whole thing. Okay, I don't like her, but she deserves an apology nonetheless. I cannot like somebody and still make an apology to him because it's the right thing to do. Don't get on a video and act like you never had a problem with Trisha Paytas, okay? You obviously had a problem with Trisha Paytas. You spoke about Trisha horribly. You called her the most horrific names. You put all this stuff out about her. You said by the time that you're done with her, that she'll be anorexic. It's like, what are these things that you're saying are so harsh? And then he said it's how he reacted to her. It was not appropriate. So, okay, I don't know who fed him that line, but thank you for taking accountability. I do appreciate that. And then he goes on and says that he apologized for what he said about Trisha Paytas. He did that. And then he said something about, okay, when he was going in, and this is kind of, I have kind of an issue with this, okay? And I actually learned about this, did you ever have those aha moments? Like, I love Oprah's aha moments. But he said in there, he doesn't know where Trisha grew up, but where he grew up, this is how people talk, okay? That people, like, put each other down. Listen, this is not shade, okay? This is not being cruel to, like, this is not just shade. This is being cruel to somebody, okay? Picking them apart. She's literally crying in a video, okay? Yes, I know that Trisha is good for hysterics, but I don't believe this is one of those situations. He came to her house, all right? And she said that she's afraid. I understand that, right? I was watching this thing with RuPaul's Drag Race, and somebody, and I can't remember who it was, but it was on Hey Queen with Johnny McGovern. This is my second video 2 days in a row that I mentioned him. This was months ago that I watched this, though. And he was interviewing somebody. I can't remember who it was, and they were from some small town. And Johnny said to them, like, how do the people in that small town treat you, you know, because you're gay or you're a drag queen or whatever. And I can't remember who it was, but they said, you know what, I don't, like, just because they're from this town or this is how they thought when they were younger, like, she was like, I can't stand that excuse that, you know, well, where I was from or when I was growing up, she was like, you know what, you're grown now. And when you're grown up, you don't talk to people that way. You know, when we know better, we do better. Are you telling me that Jay doesn't know how to talk to people? I mean, or did he show his ASS in this live stream and now he's afraid of the backlash? So that's why he's making an apology, okay? I would rather somebody not come out and make an apology and stick to their guns and say, I don't feel like anything I said was wrong, than to apologize and then say, but where I came from, this is how I talk and stuff like that. Okay, but that doesn't make it right. That doesn't make it right. You know what I mean? It's not okay. So anyway, he goes on to say that. And then he said he should have left it and, like, moved on, that he shouldn't have, and he's right, he should have. He shouldn't have played into it at all. So there's the apology. Now, I looked on Trisha's Twitter and her TikTok, and she hasn't said anything else about this. I did not look up on her back account on Instagram, but I don't believe that she said anything over there as well. So, you know, the interesting conversation last night, too, which I'm going to get to in just a second, was that Shane Dawson hasn't come out and said anything about Trisha Paytas. And I think a lot of people yesterday, because I put Shane Dawson needs to come out and defend his friend, period. I put that up on Instagram or on Twitter. And there were a lot of people that agreed with me, but there were a lot of people, and you have every right to not agree with me on this, okay? But a lot of people were like, why would he come out now? Why would this, okay? Listen, Shane Dawson has defended Jeffree Star, okay? That was a friend of his in the past over this money collab that they had, right? Trisha Paytas is supposedly one of his oldest friends. I mean, Trisha Paytas has had his back like nobody's business, right? The fact that we are 24 hours out from this and Shane Dawson hasn't gotten in an Instagram story and even just put like a post, okay, and said, it saddens me what happened to Trisha. Like, I can't continue to stand by and be okay with this, right? And this is the thing that people don't understand. So let me tell you something, okay? I think many people understand this, but I think there are some people that don't. I'm going up here and I'm looking at Jeffree Star's, you know, tweets from last night and today. And then he posted on here today, somebody put this thing about this game that somebody is using, and they're using his likeness, okay? And they said, hey, they are using your likeness in a mobile game. Just saw this ad on Facebook. And Jeffree retweets it and responds, what the F? First lawsuit of 2021 coming right up, okay? And then somebody says to him, when you are in the public eye and a major influencer, you are going to get this. Why have a lawsuit out on them? You've got enough money as it is, okay? And he responds to it, he retweets it and says, it's not about the money. The issue is using my face, brand, etc., without my permission, which is illegal. Doesn't matter how much or how little someone has, it's just not right, okay? So what we're talking about there is we're talking about principles. One of my favorite quotes ever from a movie, it was called The Contender, is that principles only mean something if you stick to them when they're inconvenient, okay? So what Jeffree Star is talking about here is that it doesn't matter how much money somebody has, nobody has a right to use his likeness in a game or anything else, right? That it's illegal and it's not okay, right? I think most of us would agree with that. I agree with that, okay? I think that that's a fair statement for Jeffree Star to make. But then when you go back and he says down here to Trisha Paytas, he responds to her and she says, if you didn't want to be, because Jeffree Star says, I've personally apologized to Trisha Paytas several times last year about Vegas and she never responded, which is her right. I respected it and what happened is between us. Don't drag me into new drama. Not interested. What someone else says does not represent me. Well, Hair by Jay was talking about Jeffree Star a lot. He was saying that Jeffree should expose Trisha Paytas, okay? He brought Jeffree's name into it a lot. It was a trip that Jeffree Star had concocted. So if he's saying that to anybody, he should be saying it to Hair by Jay, not to Trisha, because Trisha's not the one that got on a live stream and threw Jeffree Star's name out there like that. She talked about him being involved in the vlog, but she didn't pull it out, make it relevant again. So then Trisha responds and says, if you didn't want to be involved in the drama, why is he speaking your name in the video on your behalf? Confirming all the horrid SHI chat you guys said about me. I have been cool, but he is speaking on your behalf multiple times in all feeds, okay? Of which Jeffree responds, retweets it, and says, you've ignored all my messages and texts for months, yet want to have an internet circus with an audience? No, thank you. Love you, girl. You can call or text me anytime, okay? So let's talk about principles. I believe in that situation, the right thing to do would have been Jeffree Star to come out and say, yes, I do not want a drama circus. I feel horribly that somebody ever talked to you that way. You never deserve to be talked to that way. Whether we get along or not, whether we're friends or not, has no merit and no standing on whether or not you should have been spoken to that way. And I can no longer surround myself with somebody that thinks it's okay to speak to another human being that way, right? I just don't understand. You have principles when it comes to your money and suing somebody and somebody using your likeness, but where are those principles when it comes to how to treat other human beings? Am I surprised that Jeffree Star struggles with finding principles and how to treat other human beings? No, I'm not, right? But this is arrogance, ego, and pride yet again coming into play of saying, I'm not going there. No, he didn't have to get involved to do the right thing. There's a lot of people out there on YouTube that I don't like. There's a lot of people that I've had issues with in the past, okay? But if something like this happened, yeah, I think the right thing to do, if it involved me in any way, was to come out and say, I'm not okay with this, you know? Like, seriously. Seriously. Like, I mean, Jeffree Star could have done the right thing and he chose not to. So anyway, let's go over here to, I wanted to read you some of my responses. From the tweet that I put up about Shane Dawson, because I wanted to hear what people had to say about this. So, hold on just a second. Where is this? Do-do-do, do-do-do. So I put out, if you want to see something a little less dramatic, check out my video of me making my bed, because that's on my new channel, Peter Does Stuff. So I put, Shane Dawson needs to defend his friend, period. And people said, exactly, like she does him constantly, point blank, period. And someone said, and not on Insta stories, a friend of this many years deserves something better than a 24-hour story. Someone said, I think the merch pushes and standing by Jeffrey during all this is because of some sort of business contract, at least. There's no business contract that says you cannot come out and defend your friend. I'm sorry, okay? There's just not. People that want to believe in these business no business contract looks that way. And I don't believe that Shane Dawson is stupid enough to ever sign a contract like that. I don't believe that. Then someone said, is he her friend, though, after all of this? If he doesn't come out and say something, it shows more about him than it does Trisha. Someone said the icing on the cake was when he went on Ryland's podcast, shaking my head. That's beyond messed up. And that, you have to remember, okay, Ryland hasn't talked about Jeffree Star once but twice on his podcast. He had him on there, and then he also, like, talked about this stuff on there and I think had his voice or something on there the other day or called him or something. I didn't watch the podcast because, quite frankly, I think it's boring. But anyway, he was addressing the podcast again. Both of those incidents were after Trisha had talked to Shane and Ryland. She said that in her video about what happened a year ago. And they still chose to have Jeffree Star. What? No, there's not enough people out there for you to have on your podcast that you have to have the one person that physically shamed, indirectly or directly, your friend or made her uncomfortable on a trip. Like, you didn't have any problem talking about Morgan and defending Morgan on a brand trip of how cruel those people were. Do you remember that was a big deal in the series? You know that Morgan went on this brand trip and she was treated so cruelly by these influencers. Okay, well, where's your same energy when it comes to your friend that has defended you? Literally, there is nobody that has defended Shane Dawson through all of this like Trisha Paytas has. Where, and not with a phone call. Hey girl, I got your back, but you know I can't come out and say something. You've come out and you've pushed Ryland's podcast. You've come out and pushed your merch, okay? Why don't you do the right thing at the expense of maybe even losing some subscribers? That's what I don't understand, okay? It's baffling to me. So that's why I feel so strongly about the Shane thing. I don't really care at this point, like, if Shane's career is saved or not, but do I think it's the right thing for him to come out and defend his friend in this situation? Yeah, I think it's the right thing to do. Am I surprised he's not? No. I mean, like, I don't think Shane Dawson looks at Trisha Paytas as a friend the same way that Trisha looks at Shane as a friend. I just don't. I mean, y'all know, and I said it in my videos, when I met with a man, he called her a hypothetical liar, so, or pathological liar, or something like that. You know, so it's like, if that's how you talk about your friends, he said that to me, okay, with my husband sitting right there, Ryland, Garrett, and Andrew. So if that's how you talk about your friends when they're not around, does it surprise me that he doesn't get into a video and defend her or get in an Instagram story? And no, and you know what, and I don't even expect him to get on an Instagram story, or I don't even expect him to get in a video on one of his channels. Why would he do that when he hasn't posted a video and I don't even know how long? But to put something up on an Instagram story when he has tried to push his merch and he has pushed Ryland's podcast, yeah, I do think you can do that for your friend who has literally been the only person that's had your back through all of this. Someone said, wait until he comes out with his new series on himself and puts the situation in the trailer. Sound familiar? Somebody else said that they think that, this was maybe a comment, that people give Shane Dawson so much credit to this day. It's just baffling to me, right? Like, I can remember when I was covering the series and the drama and all this kind of stuff, and people were like, oh, do you think that Shane Dawson is concocting this drama in Dramageddon 2? Because then he's going to make a series of how the fallout in the beauty community, but it's not really real and there's no drama between Tati, Jeffrey, and James. Do you guys remember people used to say that? This is how much people patted the back of Shane Dawson, making him think that he was an absolute genius and all this stuff. No, Shane Dawson was not a genius when it came to all that stuff. Shane Dawson was part of the drama. We know that now, okay? That's why he didn't want to do it. He was part of the drama. I'd like to know the real footage that Shane Dawson has behind the scenes of what really went down in Dramageddon 2. That's what I'd like to know. I'd like to see the real footage out there, you know? So no, it doesn't surprise me that he hasn't come out. But somebody was like, oh, he'll make a series with he and Trisha and Jeffrey and trying to make them all be friends. Who'd care? Who'd care at this point if Shane Dawson put out a series with Jeffree Star and Trisha trying to be friends again and he's in the middle? Who'd care? Shane Dawson needs to fix his own life before he fixes Jeffree Star and Trisha Paytas' friendship. Who'd care? If I was Trisha Paytas, I'd say, peace out. I'm done with all of you. I would. You know, and then I got into this TikTok I was watching of hers yesterday. And she said in this TikTok that Jeffree Star came out and said that he doesn't support this because of these horrible, vile things. I mean, okay, but that's more than just needs to occur in a tweet. Like, I feel like Jeffree Star should have come out in an Instagram story. Hell, he comes out and shows everything else in his Instagram stories. Why didn't he come out in an Instagram story and say, what Jay said about Trisha was not appropriate? You know? People are like, he's your employee. You pay him tons and tons of money. I mean, this guy's lived a pretty good life off the back of Jeffree Star. I'm just saying, you know what I mean? Like, let's just be for real. And yes, he was the one that was supplying the wigs and all this kind of stuff. These wigs, who is affording these wigs? My God, $4,000, $7,000 worth of wigs? Whoo, it's a lot of money. It's a lot of money and a lot of pain, you know? And whenever I discuss these things, it always brings me back to that Frances McDormand quote at the end of... At the end of Fargo, if you've ever seen that movie, when the guy gets a hit out on his wife for the life insurance policy, and she's shaking her head, and she says, all of this for some money. You know, it is so sad to me, you know? All of this because of money. This is how you treat people, you know? This is how you talk about people. I don't think it matters at this point how many people come out and say that Jeffree Star speaks a certain way about people. I think there's those people out there that refuse to ever believe it, okay? I am not so concerned at this point. I know this is going to sound crazy. I am not so concerned at this point with how Jeffree Star talks about people in his life behind his back or not. Because I truly believe that enough people say something, there's probably some truth to it, right? But what makes me sad about it is, or what my concern is when is he ever going to get on video? Or when is he ever going to be willing to humanize himself enough and say, I did talk about people. I shouldn't have talked about people. You know, it wasn't the right thing to do. It wasn't nice. And yet I did it. And I called some people some names. And I'm hurt about that later. I don't want to be that person today. I want to grow. I want to change from that. I mean, that's where Jeffree Star at some point, it's like, are you ever even willing to be a little bit human towards the people around you? And by the way, to those of you that are so close to Jeffree Star, like Jay, like these hair and makeup people, we know his assistant Maddie just left. She doesn't work for him anymore. God knows what that's about. Allegedly, supposedly. Okay, but to all these people around Jeffree Star that are defending him, you're next. Just look at the pattern that it's been, okay? Back when it was Manny and Laura, they were the most horrible people in the entire world. Then Tati. Then, I mean, it's been every person that has gone, it's always been their fault, right? No, and I've said this for 2 years, the common denominator has always been Jeffree Star. And now the only people that he has around him are hair and makeup people, you know? If you like Jeffree Star, if you're somebody that supports him, I would hope that you would wish for him enough that he was able to see how he needs to maybe change some things about himself to grow as a human being and be a better version of himself. Don't we want that for everybody? Hell, I don't even care about that man that much. And I would hope for him that he would be able to grow into a great version of himself one day, you know, because he would be a happier version of himself. And other people wouldn't be affected by the negativity surrounding all of this. So anyway, let me know what you think about that in the comment section below. I love you guys, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye.